Hello YouTubers, okay, I'm back again with the circuit for the solar powered Kindle. I think we're getting a little closer. Let me explain what I've done. I've done a little bit of fiddling. If you recall from last time, I had this circuit set up which basically flip-flopped the output of the triple five timer from pin 3. I at that point in time just had a variable potentiometer on the inputs of 2 and 6, which basically meant that it was there's a fixed resistor network inside the 555, and I thought that was going to complicate things. But anyway, this, by varying the pot, you change the voltage ratio across the comparators inside the 555, and then flip flop the output. My problem was that you obviously had a fixed VCC, you are varying the input here. If you changed VCC up and down and just left that pot in a single position, the ratio was kept the same, so you didn't change the output. So the obvious thing to do, and someone suggested this as well, and I realized it's what I needed to do, but I actually took a fair bit of fiddling to get it right. I set up a voltage divider or resistor network. Not a resistor network, but basically a voltage divider using a Zener diode. So that meant that basically remove the pots to have a resistor and a Zener diode. The Zener diode I happen to be using here, but I can obviously vary it, is a 3.9 volt Zener. So then I'm holding a particular voltage ratio over the input to the 555 timer, and that's kept steady as the voltage goes up, so I can vary VCC. And this thing controls my ratio and then does the toggle. And obviously then I've got the Schmitt trigger with the hysteresis that I need. Obviously the values can be, where it triggers and what have you, can be changed by changing the Zener or changing the resistance here. But anyway, let me just demonstrate it. What I've got my variable power supply hooked up where I'm going to vary the voltage coming in. On this view here, let's go in just a little bit closer, just to tell you where things are. The variable power supply voltage is shown on the Fluke multimeter. That resistor network I was telling you about, all with the Zener, there's the resistor, here's the 3.9 volts Zener diode. This here is the 555 timer, obviously, and here are this is the LED showing the output on pin 3. And now I'm going to turn up the thing to watch is the multimeter. As I turn the voltage up, watch the LEDs as we approach around 9, 10 volts. There you go. It's toggled over at just after 10 volts. And as I come back down, it still maintains its state, which is exactly what I want, until we get down to about 4 volts. Oh, there we go, about 4.3 volts. You can see it's toggled back. So I'll just do it again. And if I go up quickly, there you go, see it toggles across. If I come down quickly, you'll see it toggles back. So that's all looking healthy. What I've now done just as a test is I've got the DC to DC converter. I'm going to put the output, the control pin, onto the output of the 555 timer. And I'm going to plug in the voltage to the DC to DC converter. So at the moment, you'll see it switched off. There's a challenge here in that DC to DC converter still wants a high current. It still wants a high current. So here we go. You can see it's toggled on. The voltage ranges where things are switching now are different, and they're different because of the characteristics of having that output. So I've got to play with the resistances in the circuit to now adjust the two trigger points when I've got the DC to DC converter attached. But as you see, as I go back down, we obviously stay on, but it'll drop out a little bit soon, around 7 volts, if I remember correctly. Bang. So there you go. You saw the toggle, and then the DC to DC converter is off, which is exactly what I want. It would then stay off. The capacitors, so they obviously that's going to come in later. The capacitors would build up their charge from the solar panel. It would reach a trigger point, activate the DC to DC converter. It'll start discharging the capacitors. It'll get down to a certain point, and then it'll toggle over and then switch off. So from this point, it's looking as though we're getting there. As I say, I still have to adjust now with this setup. I have to adjust either the zener or the resistance to get the right trigger points that I'm after, which are probably roughly around 5 volts and 9 volts. There might be a challenge when you actually come to real world test this. This DC to DC converter still can sometimes be a bit of a power hog at the point when it's trying to switch. But what I have gotten, I'll just quickly show you. This has just arrived from China, I think. I've got my 9 volt 2 watt solar panels. These are crystalline. So at very worst case, if I'm not coming right with the 6 power solar powered panel on the Amazon cover, then I might convert to 2 of these, which will provide more power. But I say I'm hoping to still use that 6 solar panel, but this is what we might switch to if need be. Anyway, I'm going to try and progress this a little bit further and hopefully have some success once I actually connect it up for a real world test again. And I say thanks again for all your input, and if you're keen to follow this series, then certainly do subscribe. And if you know anyone else who might be interested in this, certainly do share it on either your Twitter feed or Facebook. Thanks very much for watching.